Okay, so here we go again. Number 49. I'm coming up on episode 50. That's going to be the next one, so I'll definitely have to, I'm going to do something really awesome. Even though YouTube says I've uploaded 56 videos, which I have, but some of them I called like 40 part 1, 40 part 2, whereas now I keep numbering them up. So, but nonetheless, I'm going to celebrate it the way they're numbered, Beyond Raw Food. So this Beyond Raw Food 49, about magic. That is something I'm getting back into, and magic is a way. YouTube is amazing, absolutely amazing, because there's a couple people that I've become very inspired this week, and I call this week magic, big magic week, magic just exploding, the whole concept of magic and direction of energy. And anyways, there's a guy on YouTube, it's a gay guy also, and he's pretty out about that, Rob Cutter, and he is a complete magic practitioner and a wonderful lecturer on energy and the subconscious and conscious and understanding why things work the way they do. And like a lot of these things that are quote unquote magic are, you know, they're just a way of what we can already do, because the part of our brain that doesn't really work so hard and heavy is that subconscious, is the subconscious, the sort of the magic part about us that doesn't really work so well. And so the conscious part, works over that, and it should be like the subconscious should be like 85 or 90%, and the conscious should be, I mean, that's how we work. Or perhaps that's just what's conscious in us, you know. I'm sure there's a lot of definitions of that, but in terms of magic principles, the most important thing is for us to come to know ourselves, like how we see it. Like, and that's a big thing that's really gone wrong with us, is we've become hybridized from following each other, and our brain power has died. Some of us are like, we don't get it. Like, why do we have to have papers that tell us that we can do something? You know? And that's hybridization, and that's where we've gone wrong. We've become intellectual mutts, where, you know, a lot of people can't, they can't think right, you know? And some of us that still have it together, and I'm like, I guess I'm patting myself on the back, but I am a free thinker, and I've had a lot of problems being somebody that's 46 years old and has, like, tried to return to class to learn a few things that I'm interested in, like anthropology, you know, and realizing that, you know, paying to go into a class, having expectations, especially when you're kind of doing it for fun, like I am, was, and finding out that the teacher is your peer or your underling, you know, or, you know, whatever. And I took an anthropology class, and let me tell you, this freaking stupid drunk was an idiot, you know? And it was just like, I can't believe that's going on, you know? So, anyways, not to go on about that, but, so intellectually we've become too hybridized, and so we have an ability to just, you know, somebody came up with the stuff we do. Somebody came up with everything that we did first. Somebody didn't teach them. And so we're becoming very hybridized and like stuck on a mental plane and a intellectual plane, where we're just like being, you know, we're being first trapped physically, and now further on just our pure ingenuity, our creativity. Because as an artist, let me tell you, I'm amazed at how many people, I just throw lines on papers, play musical instruments, do whatever, and I just do it with freedom. And I guess in my seek to be 46 and to feel like I'm free, I don't want to be trapped by other things. So anyways, I'm ranting on this conversation about that, that we've become hybridized, and so, and even some people that are not stuck on a mode of thinking, and by a mode I mean a box, compartmentalized, or genre-lized, or where it's like, you know, you fill in these boxes, like, what are you? We're becoming like bio machines, you know, where we're just like a part, you know, so we've got to like move out of that and just somehow get as free as we can, because that's where we work best. We're the, as David Wolf calls it, we're the noble creatures on this planet, and right now we're being, our intelligence, our ingenuity, our creativity, our free will, all of that is becoming hybridized. You know, religion's a part of that, becoming good at only one thing. You know, it's, and we're evolving, you know, it's like, it's going to be pushed on us where it's like, wow, I hope a lot of people make it through this. I don't know if I'm going to. I know the one thing that I was put here to do was music, and it's not a very compartmentalized music. And so I'm having a hard time right now, though. And of course, I'm not very settled with my relationships. Last year I had a really good creative time, and I need to get back into that. That's going to make me okay. I was smoking a lot of pot doing that, and so, you know, I had to, you know, in this longevity thing, it just, marijuana is a medicinal thing, and so it's not really, that's my interest in the Chinese herbs, I have to tell you, is to get into that super consciousness that things like marijuana can get you into. I really, you know, I've done some heavier drugs, like crystal for one, speed, but more specifically the really refined crystal meth, and that's a great thing. Of course, always being somebody that's into health food, I think the amazing thing about me is the fact that I've done some pretty serious drugs, and I've been a raw foodist the whole time. That's where I know I'm not compartmentalized. And it just makes perfect sense to me that I've done that. I've stayed a raw fooder and didn't, because I had a night of doing crystal meth and had my brains like completely amplified and tuned into like my art perfectly. You know, and being, it's a spiritual thing, you know, and it's like a lot of raw foodists are just too pure, you know. You're not gonna, we by design being the noble creatures on this planet, we've got to expand our consciousness, you know, we have to expand we just can't be here and be animals. We've been so bad to ourselves, like letting the Industrial Revolution just like sort of take us into this thing where, again, where we're just becoming compartmentalized, you know, it's like people are getting into like, just fitting into like some certain thing, and like things that don't fit in that box are like shunned or moved into the next city or, you know, or whatever, they just, whatever, how things are happening now, you know, so, you know, changing your consciousness is not a bad thing, it's something that we do, and so the Chinese herbs, and really, especially Reishi, with the knowledge of things like Reishi, Lingzi, and asparagus root, the flying herb. It's like, I'm interested in those things. I'm interested in taking too much of those things, because you can't take too much of them. And they're tonic herb, which means you can take as much as you want every single day. And you can, and both of those are known for when you take them for long periods of time, they expand. They've already changed me. I'm already somebody else. I'm becoming, you know, I've decided that by the holidays, which would be Christmas, that's always been a place where I've marked time, because I was a student for a long time in my life, and for some reason I've always just thought of that as, in the point of view, idea of being a child. So by the end, by Christmas holidays, I plan on really being a person that I'm very proud of, in a way that I've never been more proud of myself ever in my life, including younger. And I'm pretty much on that path, but I just got to deal with that child in me that was like hurt, that was like not paid attention to, and not let that get in the way. So Beyond Raw Food 49, this is Keith saying peace out.